Here we go.
Autobots. No, that was bad. Hold on. Autobots, roll out.
Not bad for a little tiny female.
Hi, y'all. I'm Liza Koshy, and I'm going to answer 20 questions for 2023. To prepare for the role of RC, I ride now. She's a Ducati 916, and I ride a stationary bike. I cycle. I really did work out for this role, though. I hope you can hear it in my inflection, in my voice, that I'm ripped. She's gorgeous, and she's got curvaceous body, so I tried to create my own so that I could step into both of our power. Of all time, I'm from Houston, Beyonce. What do you mean? Do I not reek of that? I love B. I haven't scored tickets yet, though. Okay, I'm mad about it. I'll find my way there. Least favorite food, I think, would have to be, it's weird. I know I'm gonna get flack for this, but watermelon, it's a weird texture. The texture of it feels like a kidney. I don't know, I've never eaten a kidney, but that's what I imagine the texture of it feeling like. It feels like it's an old sponge that falls apart in your mouth. It's gritty. It feels like it just cleaned something. It doesn't make sense. I love the flavor, not the texture. I'm a texture girl. My favorite food, I think, is chocolate. Chocolate covered espresso beans. There we go. Those keep me going throughout the day. I would transform into a refrigerator because it's got a lot of options of sauces in it, and people think about me in the middle of the night and they come to me. Always stocked. Everything, all labels facing outwards. There's lines of four cans each. You know, you got your options. You've got every sauce fully full, not the like little drips at the bottom. You've got everything you need. I have had a crush on an animated character, and I have taste, and everybody else does too. Everybody loved this man, Danny Phantom. The way his jaw was drawn, the way his eyes glowed green, the way his hair was built by a man on a piece of paper. He is stunning, okay? I had a big fat crush. The song that I have on repeat right now is a song by Conan Gray, young Gen Z icon. He has a song called Never Ending Song right now, and it's really good. It brings back like old like 80s beats. Like it should be in the Stranger Things soundtrack. It's so good. My mom. That's it. My family. That is my safe space, my safe haven out in H-Town, my family. Voice acting secrets for this one, I wore spandex to feel like a superhero in the booth. Like full on black, like broad shoulders. I stood with the best posture of my life. My hands were in fists most of the time to feel like I was in a power pose. I think at some point it went on my hips. I fully was like woman spreading in the booth too. I took up space, and that's what she does. Trypophobia is pretty irrational. I think it's irrational because it was birthed from the internet, but why do they have to be that close? It's unnecessary. The holes, it's terrifying. I hate it. I don't know what's in those holes. I don't want to know what comes out. Oh, I've been saying this for years. R-E-S-P-E-C-T by Aretha Franklin. Yup. Ooh, that's such a good question. What song would I ride to? The song of choice would be, they see me rolling out. They hate it. Patrolling, they're trying to catch me riding. R-C. Most starstruck I've ever been was when I had the honor and privilege of interviewing President Barack Obama. That was wild to see that man match the essence that he is in media, in person, but even greater. We had this idea of who leaders might be the moment they walk into the room, and he just met every expectation and definition and then superseded them too. He's magnificent. So just a good person. I think my earliest Transformers memory would be seeing it with my older cousins, just not blinking at the screen because of how much CGI and how many special effects and explosions were going on. Like, your eye was eating. And I can't wait for people to see this new iteration in the 90s in Brooklyn that has so much to eat up to. Ooh, favorite book of all time is The Alchemist. Love The Alchemist. You can read it at different points in your life and you'll pick up new points to take away with you. Biggest pet peeve? It's weird, it's so specific, but number two pencils, it's so gritty. There's a sound to it, and I'm sensitive. So that grittiness, that scratch that it has when it's not fine point, a mechanical pencil always has the fine point, but number two, if it's dull, it has like a scratch, like nails on chalkboard. I can't stand it. I just need you to use a mechanical pencil, okay? It's 2023. I just can't stand. The yellow choice too, it's a lot. I'm trying to think who would be great, like as a Transformer. Michelle Obama. Why not make her a Transformer? When I meet someone that recognizes me in person, I tend to get like Vine or TikTok or
Transformers. Like whatever the most recent release of something I've done, they'll just like yell that at me. But also Liza, they'll say my name too. But I love when someone mentions Vine because that's where it all starts.
The riskiest? I made a TikTok in a hospital gown and I flashed the camera a little bit, but I censored it and it got blocked. So you can't see it anymore. But I censored it. Everybody has an ass. It doesn't make sense. It's fine. Let the cheeks air out.
When people watch Transformers Rise of the Beast, they will have a conniption.
There is a lot to see, and there's a lot of expectations we're going to supersede. So there is so many layers, so many Easter eggs, so many moments that have led up to this massive one. This is going to be like a time capsule of sorts. The nostalgia is going to hit for so many people. The 90s, Brooklyn, old 90s hip hop, Toby being from Houston, Toby Wigwe, I mean, and him, contributing to the soundtrack and just making the score all the more yummier with his sound. There's so much to see and so much to behold. So I think new fans, old fans alike are gonna love it.
I hope you guys learned a little bit more about me, and make sure to check out Transformers Rise of the Beast coming out June 9th.